useful. You can see my contact information here on the page, and I hope you will all feel free to contact me directly if you have any questions later, and I'll give you some more information later on about where you can find more details about our project. I hope you have a great meeting. Sorry I can't be there, and I hope you find this helpful. I'm going to be introducing SocArXiv, which is a project group we started last year, a group of sociologists and librarians and I. And we hope it's a useful tool for you. I'll give you a little bit of description of when and how to use it, some of the benefits, what we think it offers, and sort of give you a pep talk on why you might like to consider it that I hope you'll consider. So first I'll just describe what SocArXiv is. I will sort of define the content that we host for you, working papers, preprints, postprints, give you a little bit of the rationale for why to share, discuss questions about when is the appropriate time, how to make the decision about when you want to share your work in this open venue, and then address some of the common concerns that people raise when they start thinking about taking this step in their workflow and their careers. So, to jump right in, SocArXiv is an open archive of the social sciences. It's a free service that hosts research papers. It's hosted by the Nonprofit Center for Open Science on their preprint service. There's a number of other preprint communities that are called on this system. We're a community of scholars and librarians trying to build research infrastructure for the public good. So it's something that we hope will help all of us improve our research and its impact as we try to find our way in this scholarly communication world. For more information, you should feel free to visit our blog and website, which is called socopen.org. There's a frequently asked questions page that gets into a lot of detail of what I'm going to talk about today, and there's also a tutorial there you can walk through and a link to a tutorial video and a bunch of other materials on socopen.org. So I hope you'll visit there if you have more questions as I go. So what do you put on SocArXiv? What do we host? Sort of three definitions of papers. Any paper is fine, any research paper is fine to put on SocArXiv. The main categories, the sort of moments in the research process that people upload their papers are working papers, preprints, and postprints. Those are not rigid definitions, but those are the terms that people use. Our working papers are essentially drafts of papers that are ready to read, things you're ready to show other people, but have not yet been peer-reviewed. And the implication of using the term working paper is that there are additional revisions to come. It's not a final product, but it's something that is ready to be read and shared. This term is used commonly in some social sciences like economics. They always talk about working papers, somewhat in sociology and somewhat less in other disciplines. So if that's a word that you use in your discipline, that work is welcome on SocArXiv. Preprints have some overlap with working papers, but they imply something more like a finished draft, something that may be ready to be peer-reviewed, or even something that has been accepted, gone through the peer-review process, but is not yet in print, whatever print means anymore. For some people, this is an important distinction because they're definitely not peer-reviewed. So, for example, some journals in sociology will not consider your work if it has already been peer-reviewed or been presented in a peer-review format somewhere. So if you're considering it as a preprint, that means you've distributed the work, but it has not been subject to peer review, and you can submit it to a journal. It will be considered an original submission and something that they can have an exclusive right to peer review and then distribute if they accept it. So that's what preprints tend to be. And then postprints often are the open access version of a published paper. That is, if something has been peer reviewed, depending on the rights you've negotiated with the publisher, your author agreement, it may be the version with or without the journal editing and formatting, but the postprint is when you can say, my work has been peer reviewed, it has been accepted, it is either in or will soon be in this peer reviewed journal, and here's a free copy that's not paywalled that we can share and discuss and read and benefit from while it's also being published by a journal. So again, this is subject to the author agreements that you have with your journals, but the postprint is something, is a version that you can share of something that has already been published. OK, Okay, well, why do this? We think that opening up your work is going to make it more efficient, more engaging, and more inclusive. And I have sort of broken out some of the benefits here into three categories of time, access, and connection. Time is a really big one, and for a lot of people, this is all the motivation they need. We are accustomed in academia to wait months or longer for people who really are having their arms twisted to even read our work. They may not want to read our work, but they volunteered or gotten cajoled into it. And meanwhile, there are people who do want to read it, who may be excited about it, or maybe potential collaborators, people we might want to work with, and people that we really want to get it out to, who don't have access to it during that process. So SocArXiv and other paper servers, but ours in particular, are there for you to get that work out earlier. Okay. Well, we're also going to increase access to your work. That is, you want your work to reach people, but too often it's locked up. It's behind a paywall, and even if the public has paid for it through some sort of state funding of research, it may not be accessible to the public, which is just a source of constant frustration for many of us, not to mention the librarians who are paying in charge of managing the budgets for subscriptions and so on. So a paper server like SocArXiv can be a way to manage and get the work out there. It's going to get it out on Google Scholar and Google and other search engines and have it be discovered and read without people having to pay for it. Again, assuming you haven't signed away your right to distribute it under those conditions. And then finally, the category of connection. Sharing work earlier and more often and more openly is a way to connect with more scholars, to deepen your engagement with other audiences, including publics, including non-academic publics. And our sense is that this is a way for us to reclaim the process of publication, that scholars and librarians should control the publishing process rather than the for-profit publishers who so often do now. So nothing against them, but often what they're doing is not something that we actually need them to do. It's something that we can do and maybe even do better and more efficiently and faster on our own. So that's some of the rationale for why to share papers. When should you share papers? Well, it's too often we hear people describing work that they're doing in isolation. How many times have you heard a colleague say, "I've got a great paper coming out, wait till you see it," instead of saying, "I've got a great paper, here it is." So we want to get there sooner. So when you want feedback for your work, when you want to engage with potential collaborators or current collaborators, that's a key time to get it out. Moments when you're already sharing it are often a good time to think about, okay, this might be the right time. You're submitting it to a conference, in which case it's going to be read and reviewed by a group of strangers already, or you're making a commitment to publish it already. So you're not really hiding it. You may as well consider sharing it at that moment. Similarly, when you submit it to a journal, that's also going to be shown to a group of strangers, and so why not show it to those people who are out there in your public, who might be on your platform or in your social media world, or among your colleagues and potential collaborators who might like to see it right then. Certainly, when a paper has already been accepted is a great time. Then you can say, my work has been peer-reviewed. My work is forthcoming in a journal. It has received this evaluation that tells you that it's legitimate, and I'd like to share it with you now in an open format, in a free format, an accessible format, so we don't have to wait for the journal to get around to publishing it in print or however they publish it. And then, of course, after the paper is published, especially if it's behind a paywall, putting that postprint on SocArXiv can be the way that you get it into more people's hands quickly. And what SocArXiv is going to be able to do in any of these cases is provide a link forward to the journal that ended up publishing it. So you can say, here's my preprint or my postprint on SocArXiv, and there's a link to the DOI, the record locator that will take it right to the journal page if they want to see that that accepted version or that formatted version from the journal. So by distributing it on SocArXiv, you may be getting a free copy out, a copy out sooner, but you're still providing that record link and all that metadata that goes along with that to the peer-reviewed version, which is going to be very important for those of us in academia. Okay. Well, why not share your work? It turns out there are a number of common concerns, and these are things we've heard a variety of times, enough times that is, that it's been worth making a note about them and try to head some of these questions off, things for you that might not be good enough. Maybe it's not ready. We want to help talk you out of that and help you get to the point of realizing that it's okay to be proud of your work and to share it, and still respect and use the peer review process. Some people are self-conscious about promoting their own work, but we think that's your job. You're doing the work, and part of doing the work is finding audiences for it, people who should read it. Obviously, it's got to be good for something, or else we wouldn't be doing it. So it may be good enough, and part of that is getting over the fear and also the realization and the experience of making mistakes and learning from them and admitting them and moving on from them. So, it's good practice, and not always so easy, of course, but we'd like you to believe in your work and believe it's good enough, and we all make mistakes. Another common concern is that if I post my preprints or working papers now, I won't be able to publish it later. Someone will find it online and say, oh, we won't consider it for our journal because it's already been published and our journal only publishes original work. That is a problem with some journals. However, most journals will publish papers that have been shared as long as they haven't been peer-reviewed. In my discipline of sociology, the American Sociological Association has an explicit policy that permits sharing of work before it's reviewed by their journals as long as it has not been peer-reviewed. There are some journals that have limitations and they won't consider work that has been shared at all. And all I can say in response to that is maybe consider publishing in a different journal. We have choices about how to share our work. And a journal that takes a policy like that may not have your best interests or the interests of your audience and readers at heart. So something to consider, but usually not a problem. Number third common concern, some will take my idea. I'll put my work out there, someone will see my good idea. This is the opposite of the it's not good enough, this is the it's too good fear. Someone will take my really good idea and steal it, repurpose it, and use it for themselves before I have a chance to publish it. We think this is although understandable to think this way, it's actually backwards. By posting your work early, publicly, with a timestamp, and sharing it widely, you're actually protecting yourself from future problems of people stealing your work. In fact, of course, most work that is stolen is not stolen by random strangers. It's good ideas taken by people's, sorry to say, mentors, advisors, committee members, colleagues, people who already know about your work. And it's just better protection for yourself to get it out there and publicly put your name on it earlier. So that's our argument on that. There's an additional set of concerns which may be somewhat less common but still arise to discuss. Open access is basically low quality. It's for people who can't publish in real journals. It looks kind of desperate. And there is a lot of junk open access out there in the world, and there's nothing we can do about that at the moment. However, we don't think that should stop us from understanding that open is better for our work. That we need to change the culture, we need to be the change, so to speak, and we have to live with that. We're not going to tell you, and you can't tell your friends, that by putting your work on SocArXiv that makes it good. It does not make it good. There's bad work on SocArXiv. There's bad things on the internet, and we still use the internet. So just by putting it on SocArXiv gives you no prestige. It gives you no evaluation of the quality. What it does do is give it a platform for being discovered and distributed and shared with people who might want to read it. So there's nothing to do except try to change that culture. In addition to having the fear of having your ideas stolen by another academic is the possibility that somebody will take your work and simply sell it or put it in a book or something and make money off it. This is quite unlikely, no offense, it's never happened to me, so probably won't happen to you. However, if it does happen, it's really not so bad. You want people to read it. If someone can figure out a way to make money from your academic work and without stopping you from distributing it for free, that's usually a good thing if it does happen. Don't forget that most journals you're planning to publish in are planning to make a profit off the work that you're giving them for free. The key thing to remember is you will still be able to distribute it for free, always on SocArXiv or wherever else you want. So even if you give it a non-restrictive license, like a CC0 license that allows somebody to sell it if they want to, they can't sell it as an exclusive thing, which is the way most for-profit publishing works. So if they can find a way to sell it, package it, put a cover on it or something, concerns, finally, of people who have published work and they're afraid they don't have a right to share it. And we find people sometimes vacillate between extremes. Either they share everything without regard to the rights that they may have signed away, or they're afraid to share anything. The key thing is to consult your author agreement, and you can also negotiate or change your author agreements when you're publishing. There's also the Sherpa Romeo, if you Google that, is a database of journal policies, which is not guaranteed to be accurate, but is usually accurate for what the policy of the journal might be. So I'm not allowed to share my work after 12 months, or a final version or not, and so on. So that's a good thing to check. So in conclusion, better, faster, more efficient, more engaging, more responsive publishing that we control. I'm happy to tell you that while you are having Open Access Week, we are having Open Access Week here at the University of Maryland. We're having our own Open Scholarship for the Social Sciences Conference later this week. I'm sorry I can't be there with you. We'll be having it again next year if all goes well, so look for the announcements and consider submitting your work next year, next time we do it. I know that you will have a lot of other questions and issues and discussion. I'm sorry I can't be there to take them individually, but please see the contact information here. I'm Family Unequal on Twitter. I'm PNC at UMD on email, SocArXiv